Yeah, guys, already Isaac has forced Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal to cancel his trip to the convention as his state is now under a state of emergency. Same goes for Alabama Governor Robert Bentley. And now the GOP has a bit of a balancing act on its hands as it celebrates the nomination of Mitt Romney while remaining sensitive to the threat that Isaac poses to hundreds of thousands of Gulf Coast residents.
After putting the finishing touches over the weekend in New Hampshire on what could be the most important speech of his career, Mitt Romney will still be the headliner at the Republican National Convention. But it is a top billing he'll have to share with a storm named Isaac. And former New Hampshire Governor John Sununu, already in Tampa, is hopeful the convention won't need to be amended further.
Look, we're worried about the poor folks that are going to be on the brunt end of this hurricane. But beyond that concern, which is a very big concern, I think that the rescheduling is not going to have a significant impact.
But what the circumstances will be in the coming 24 to 48 hours remains very much unclear. And ABC News political director Amy Walter says the Romney campaign and the Republican Party as a whole find themselves in a tough spot.
You know, I think the worst case scenario is that there are scenes of devastation along the Gulf Coast, while at the same time, Republicans are having what looks like a very rowdy pep rally. So that's really the concern for Republicans.
One certainty is at the end of the convention, whenever that is, Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan will officially be the Republican ticket. And Walter says the goal of the Romney campaign doesn't have to be a home run in Tampa, but deliver a message that will simply boost his lagging favorability heading into the fall.
Doesn't need to get people to fall in love with him, but maybe like him a little bit more or dislike him a little bit less. That will have been a success for Mitt Romney.
All right, so ahead of Isaac making landfall, we can expect tomorrow to be a packed day at the convention. Kelly Ayotte will be making a speech, as will the aforementioned John Sununu. And Ann Romney, who was supposed to headline tonight, will now also be speaking tomorrow. Any other schedule changes, though, it seems, will be dictated by what happens with Isaac. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.